Hello friends, I am Dr. S.K. Mittal. In this lecture, I will explain the working of three-phase fully controlled AC to DC converter with resistive load for different firing angles. Now, first of all, what is fully controlled AC to DC converter? An AC to DC converter which contains controlled devices is known as fully controlled AC to DC converter. The fully controlled devices are semiconductor devices or SCRs. Therefore, to construct the circuit diagram of three-phase fully controlled AC to DC converter, we will consider six SCRs, because for generating AC to DC from three-phase, we require in each phase two SCRs. Therefore, for three-phase, we require total six SCRs. Now, see here, these are the six SCRs. These three SCRs will be connected to three-phase supply where I am assuming that this three-phase AC supply is having phase sequence ABC. And now, this is the three-phase AC supply. This AC supply is connected to three-phase fully controlled AC to DC converter. Since all the SCRs in this circuit, therefore it is fully controlled. Now, if we give the names, the upper group SCRs which are connected to upper line are represented generally by T1, T3, T5, and in lower group the SCRs are represented by T4, T6 and T2. Now, this is the supply and this is the AC to DC converter fully controlled, and this is connected to a resistive load between output terminals A and B. Now, here will be the current, output current, and since DC is being obtained, therefore this is the output voltage. Now, this circuit is consisting of T1, T3, T5 in upper line. These upper line SCRs T1, T3 and T5 are known as positive group SCRs, whereas the lower line connected SCRs T4, T6 and T2 are known as negative group SCRs. T1, T3, T5 are known as positive group SCRs because these SCRs are connected with most positive voltages. What is most positive voltage, I will explain in the waveform later on. Whereas the lower group SCRs T4, T6 and T2 will conduct with most negative voltages. Therefore, these are known as negative group SCRs. In case of resistive load, this three-phase fully controlled AC to DC converter, it generally operates in two modes. The first operating mode is the continuous operating mode. In continuous operating mode, the firing angle varies from 0 to 60 degree or pi by 3, whereas in discontinuous mode, fire angle alpha varies from pi by 3 to 2 pi by 3. Now see, here we have applied 3 phase AC supply in the phase sequence of ABC. Therefore, in electrical engineering, these 3 phase voltages, for example, VA is equal to VM sin omega t. Other phase voltage VB will be displaced by 120 degree with respect to A phase voltage, and it will be lagging in nature. Therefore, it is represented by Vm sin omega t minus 120 degree because the supply is balanced. And another phase voltage Vc is represented by Vm sin omega t minus 240 degree. So these are the various phase voltages or three phase voltages applied to input of three phase fully controlled AC to DC converter. Now see, the voltages which I have represented by three equations VA, VB and VC are represented by this waveform. Here, say, the VA phase starts from omega t is equal to 0, whereas the second phase voltage VB starts from omega t is equal to 120 degree, therefore it is lagging by 120 degree with respect to A phase voltage. At the same time, the third phase voltage VC starts from omega t is equal to 240 degree, therefore it is lagging with respect to A by 240 degree and with respect to B by 120 degree. Therefore, this is the three phase waveform which are represented in previous equations 1, 2 and 3. Now this is the applied voltage to the three phase fully controlled AC to DC converter. Now we will observe that where T1, T3, T4, T5, T6 other SCRs will start conducting from alpha is equal to 0 degree. First I am considering the firing angle alpha is equal to 0 degree. See, these are the crossings above the x-axis and these are the crossings below the x-axis. We will observe the maximum positive voltage and maximum negative voltage on these crossings. See, this is the crossing at omega t is equal to 30 degree, Therefore, at omega t is equal to 30 degree, here we see that this is the VC. VC starts from here and it is going in this direction. Whereas VA starts from here and goes in this direction. At the same time, VB is totally negative at omega t is equal to 30 degree. Therefore, we can say that at omega t is equal to 30 degree or after omega t is equal to 30 degree up in upper side of x-axis, VA is the most positive voltage. See here, the circuit diagram. In the circuit diagram, T1 is connected to A line and at omega t is equal to 30 degree, VA is most positive and T1 is connected to this line. Therefore, at omega t is equal to 30 degree, we will consider alpha is equal to 0 degree. Because at omega t is equal to 30 degree, VA is more positive and with this VA, T1 SCR is connected. Therefore, for firing angle alpha is equal to 0, we will apply gate signal at omega t is equal to 30 degree for alpha is equal to 0 degree firing angle. So now here, we will turn on SCR T1. In fully controlled bridge rectifier, every SCR conducts for 120 degree, whether it is from positive group or whether it is from negative group. Now see, this is the another crossing. First SCR T1 is triggered at omega t is equal to 30 degree for alpha is equal to 0 degree. From omega t is equal to 30 degree, 120 degree is completed at omega t is equal to 150 degree. Now at 150 degree, T1 will be commutated and another SCR will be triggered which is connected to more positive voltage. Now see here, at omega t is equal to 150, VA is going like this. VC is totally negative, whereas VB is going towards upper side. Therefore, we can see that VB becomes more positive at omega t is equal to 150 or at where with VB, which SCR is connected from B line? B line is connected to T3 SCR. Therefore, here at omega t is equal to 150 degree, T3 will be triggered. Now, see, at another zero crossing, which is obtained at omega t is equal to 270 degree, at this which voltage is being more positive, VA is totally negative, VB is going downwards whereas VC is going upward side, and with VC line, RC line, T5 is connected from upper group or positive group. Therefore, here VC is the more positive and here T5 will be triggered. Now between T3 and T5 there is 120 degree gap, means T3 conducts for 120 degree. It starts from 150 and commutated at 270. Now here is another crossing at omega t is equal to 390 degree. At 390 degree, which voltage is more positive? We observe on similar lines, VA is positive and with VA, positive group SCR T1 is connected. Now, for alpha is equal to 0, T1 is triggered at omega T is equal to 30 degree, T3 is triggered at 150 degree, T5 is triggered at 270 degree, and again T1 will be triggered at omega T is equal to 390 degree, means each positive group SCR will conduct for 120 degree. Now see, this is the negative side below x-axis. At this zero crossing, which occurs at omega T is equal to 90 degree, now we will investigate which voltage is more negative. See here, this is the VB going upward. VA is positive at omega T is equal to 90. Therefore, we can say that VC is going to be more negative. And if VC is going to be more negative, therefore with VC or with C line, which SCR is connected, T2 SCR is connected. Therefore, at omega T is equal to 90 degree for alpha is equal to 0 degree, we will trigger T2. Now, another zero crossing occurs at 210 degree. Now, at 210 degree, which voltage is going to be more positive? See here, VC is going towards upward, VB is positive, and VA is going to be more negative side. Therefore, with VA or with A line, which SCR is connected from negative group, with A line, T4 is connected. Therefore, at omega T is equal to 210 degree, from negative group, for alpha is equal to 0, T4 SCR will be triggered. Now, another crossing is occurring at omega T is equal to 30 degree. From previous discussion, we can say that VB becomes more negative here, and if VB becomes more negative, VA is going upward side, VC is positive, means VB is more negative, and with VB, negative group SCR or B line, which SCR is connected, T6 is connected. Now at omega T is equal to 330 degree, T6 SCR will be triggered. And after that, here after T6, T2 will be triggered. So this is the various triggering points of positive group SCRs and negative group SCRs for three-phase fully controlled AC to DC converter. Now, we will investigate that, say here, from the waveform, at omega T is equal to 30 degree, T1 starts conducting and it conducts till 150 degree for 120 degree. Now T3 is triggered at 150 degree. It conducts for 120 degree and it is commuted at 270. Now T5 is turned on at 270 degree. It conducts till 390 degree for 120 degree, and then T1 will again start conducting. Say here, if we see that T1, T3, T5 and then T1. Before T1, we are observing that T5 is conducting. Therefore, for this 30 degree, which SCR will conduct, we can say T5 will conduct. Now, say here, at omega T is equal to 90 degree, negative group SCR, T2 starts conducting, now it is T2. It conducts till omega t is equal to 210 degree for 120 degree. Now T4 starts conducting from omega t is equal to 210 degree. So we will mark T4. It will conduct till 330 degree for 120 degree, and then T6 will conduct for again 120 degree, and then T2 will start conducting after T6. Now see, before T2, T6 is conducting, and this distance is of 90 degree. Therefore, for 90 degree, which SCR will conduct before T2? T6. So here I will observe T6. Now see this first point obtained from positive group is T5 from 30 till 30 degree. Therefore, I will start from this. Now from 0 degree to this 30 degree, which SCRs are conducting? T5 and T6. First, I will mark positive group SCR, and then I will mark negative group SCR. So then T5 is positive group, T6 is negative. I am writing T5, T6. Now from 30 degree to 90 degree, T1 and T6 are conducting. T1 is from positive group, T6 is from negative group. Now from 90 degree to 150, T1 and T2 are conducting. T1 is from positive group. Now from 150 to 210 for 60 degree, which SCRs are conducting? From positive group T3 and from negative group T2. For this period, T3 and T4. T3 is from positive group. For this, T5 and T4. From this, T5, T6. Now see, if two SCRs are conducting for every 60 degree here, one from positive group and one from negative group. Now see this circuit diagram. T1 is connected to A line and T6 is connected to B line. Therefore, this T1 and T6 will form a line voltage VAB. Now, from 90 degree to 150, T1 and T2 are conducting. T1 is connected to A line, whereas T2 is connected to C line. Therefore, here by the conduction of T1 and T2, line voltage obtained will be VAC. Now, in the next 60 degree, T3 and T2 are conducting. T3 is connected to B line and T2 is connected to C line. Therefore, this voltage will be represented by VBC. Now, for next, T3 and T4 are connected. T3 is connected to B line and T4 is connected to A line. Therefore, it will be VBA. T3 is connected to B line and T4 is connected to A line. Therefore, this line voltage will be VBA. Now, here T5, T4 are conducting. T5 is connected to C line, whereas T4 is connected to A line. Therefore, this line voltage will be T5 is connected to C line and T4 is connected to A line. So, this voltage will be VCA. In this way, we can nomenclature this line voltages obtained by conduction of two SCRs for every 60 degree. Now, for this 30 degree, T5 and T6 are conducting. T5 is connected to C line and T6 is connected to B line. Therefore, this line voltage for this 30 degree will be VCB. So, these are the various line voltages obtained from the conduction of two SCRs for every 60 degree. Now, in general, we can say that every positive group SCR conducts for 120 degree, whereas every negative group SCR conducts for again 120 degree, but for every 60 degree, one SCR conducts from positive group and one SCR conducts from negative group, and therefore for every 60 degree line voltage is obtained. Now I have calculated these are the line voltages, and these line voltages will be calculated and then we will obtain the waveform. Now, from the waveform, we have obtained these line voltages. Now, our next aim is to calculate these line voltages and to draw the output voltage of these line voltages in terms of these line voltages. This calculation and output waveform we will obtain in the next lecture. Thank you.